In Parashat HaShavua, Parashat Vayetzeh, the Torah tells us what happened with Yaakov Avinu, that only went on the way and he slept in the place of the Beit HaMikdash, the temple. He had a dream, and in his dream he saw a very big sulam,
ladder.
And on this ladder, he saw angels who are going up and going down. And on this dream, the Gemara said that the angel who he saw in his dream was going up to the Shamayim and saw on the through where the chair where Hashem is sitting. The face of Yaakov Avinu, and they come down and see his face. So the same face in the Kisei HaKavod, in the place where Hashem is sitting, and also down. So they were so jealous, they wanted to do something will be dangerous for Yaakov. So the pasuk continued and said, Ve'ineh Hashem nitzav alav. Hashem came and stand up next to him to protect him from the malachim who wants to do something dangerous for Yaakov. And the Gemara continued and said that our Hashem protect him, that he took like somebody, a father, who takes a fine for to do the wind to his child. And Rashi explained why the example of the Torah, the Gemara, is that Hashem is like a father who is taking a fan to do wind to his son to protect him from the place where it was too hot, from the sharav, which said too much hot. So Rashi said, so Hashem did that the place where he's sleeping will be more
heat,
cold, and not too heat, like too warm or too much warmer like it was. The Maharsha said to ask a question on Rashi. In the Midrash doesn't say that Hashem protect him from the heat, but Hashem protect him from the fly and mosquito. And Rashi even said the example of a child who is sleeping and fly and mosquito are coming on him, and the father with a fan push them away. So the Marsha said that we have to explain the Gemara like the Midrash, that Hashem want to protect him from the zevuv, which means fly or mosquito, but not from the heat. But we are going to see that Rashi is so big a mekubal, and when what he said is exactly like the Midrash, and we are going to explain why. The Gemara in Berachot, when she speaks about Elisha, when he was going on the way, every time he went next to the home of Shulamit, he was a guest in the home of Shulamit. He was staying there, sleeping there, eating by Shulamit and her husband. And the pasuk says that Shulamit said one to her husband, listen, Elisha, it's a ish kadosh over alenu. It's a holy man who is staying by us every time he's coming. And the Gemara said, ask how Shulamit knew that Elisha is a holy man. And we've got two rabbanim in the Gemara, Rav and Shmuel. One says that she was, every time she did the bed where he was sleeping, she put the sheets, She saw that every time the sheets were clean. She never found on the sheet the zera lebatala. He never had a curry, he never had a zera lebatala. So she said, and the Gemara explains that somebody who is traveling from a place to another place, because in the time of the Gemara, people who was traveling was going so much way. When they were sleeping, it was normal that could have a zera lebatala curry. But Elisha never. She never see in his sheet something. So for that, she knew that he's holy. The Zohar said that usually when somebody is sleeping in a bed, after the bed is a smell is not so good. By him, he went every time the bed that would smell. But the other opinion said no. When she was preparing on the morning, two small tables, one table for Elisha, and not far from him, another small table for the Shamash of Elisha, whose name was Gehazi. And we know that Gehazi was Russia. And she saw that before they came to sit, she put already a lot of meal in both tables, so the fly and the mosquito was coming next to the table because it's a meal is there. And when Elisha was sitting, all the fly and the mosquito was going away from his table and the way was going to the table of Gehazi. From that she knew she is holy. Of course, the question is, how is a tzaddik? But why? Because a fly doesn't come to his table, it proves that he's holy. You can say tzaddik, but not holy. And the answer is that Rabbi Shimshon Mostofoli was a very, very big mekubal that the goyim killed 400 years ago, is writing in one of his Sefarim that the Malach, the angel who is responsible of people who has curry, his name is Zevuv, fly or mosquito, because Zevuv is both of them. And somebody who never see curry, the fly and the mosquito, doesn't come to him. They are going away from him. So if we see Be'etzem, but really the two opinions are the same. We speak about somebody who is holy because he never see curry from in his life. And the Ahu Shulamit didn't know that. One of the opinions said because she never saw that on the sheets of his bed. But the other opinion says because she saw that all the fly and the mosquito was going away far from his table. So both are accept that why he's holy because he didn't see curry. Now we have to understand what is dangerous when it's too hot or if fly and the mosquito are coming on somebody. It's not a sakana, it's a dangerous. So what means the Gemara that the Malachi want to do that will be a danger for Yaakov? I saw by the Rav Nathan Adler, from him I understood how to explain all that. Why the Malachim was so jealous of Yaakov? Because they saw that Yaakov, his face was also down, and also Bashamayim in the place where Hashem is sitting, in the chair, the throne where Hashem is sitting. And why only Yaakov had this privilege, this zechut, that his face was in a kisei hakavod? Because the only one who never saw curry in his life, it was Yaakov. Even Avraham Yitzchak wasn't didn't have this zehut that never secured the life. So the malachim want to make a danger, was something dangerous, not for the gashmi, for the body of Yaakov, but for his soul. They wanted his going to lost this zehut, and what they did, when it's too hot, too warm to it, people are coming to carry. So they wanted to do that Yaakov will see Kerry, and if he's going to see Kerry, what will happen on the future? Fly and mosquito will come on him. So the Midrash, who knew all that, the Midrash said Hashem come to protect him from the fly and the mosquito. Doesn't mean that now, but it means that on the future. And Rashi understood what wants to say the Midrash when he said Hashem want to protect him from the fly and the mosquito. It means that he's not going to see Kerry. So what has to do Hashem? To do the place where he's sleeping will be colder and not so hot, like to do the Malachim. For that Rashi said that Hashem, how will protect him? He took a fan and do wind on him to do the place colder. And automatically, it will be protected from the fly of the mosquito. This is not a contradiction between Rashi and the Midrash. The Marshad, he knew that. For that, he decided to say, no, like Rashi, but like the Midrash. That really Rashi doesn't say something else of the Midrash. But we can see something very important. Where the Shevatim? Yaakov. Why Yaakov is the, we call him, Behir Shebavot. The best of the Avot, because Hashem, what he wants, people who are holy. Of course, nobody can be like Yaakov in our generation. Everyone can make a mistake. But we know also what Hashem said. What the Gemara says, Bimkom Shebale Teshuvah Omdim En Tzadikim Gemurim Yecholim La'amod. In the place where the Bale Teshuvah are standing, even the tzaddikim, Gemurim, doesn't can't stand there, because it's more difficult for a Baal Tshuva not to fall down in the Nisayon than a tzaddik who never had the Nisayon, who never fall down. And even so, the Baal Tshuva not to us to be strong, to never to fall again in this Nisayon, Hashem loves him, and he's even bigger than the tzaddik Gamur. And we have to work. If we want to work to on this way to become holy, first we have to keep on the eyes. It's impossible to look everywhere what we want and after not to make a mistake. If you don't want to fight with the Yetzirah, if you don't want to have a war with the Yetzirah, it will be so strong that it can push you down. Keep your eyes. Doesn't look on what you haven't got to look. You'll feel so better. No war, no fighting. Just how to know to keep the eyes. Velo taturu achare levavchem v'achare einechem. The Torah came and say, don't listen to you, to your lev, and don't look on the best place. Why is this pasuk on the parasha of tzitzit? Because you have to know that when we have the tzitzit out of the cloth, like that, tzitzit has to be out of the cloth. So when we look on the tzitzit help not to look on the arayot. It's for that Torah in the same place when she said, Daber el ben Yisrael tel masulayim tzitzit al kanfei bigdeim edorotam, that they have to wear beged of tzitziot. Continue to write and says, Velo taturu ahare levavchem v'ahare einechem. Don't go. When you can have the power not to listen to Yetzirah and not to look on a place where not to look, when you look on the tzitziot. For that it's very important, not only to wear a talit katan, but to take, to put the tzitziot out, and to look on them, and see what you can protect the fellow. It will be easy to be stronger than the Yetzer Hara. It's very important. It's a way how to work Hashem the first to become holy, not to go after the Yetzirah for the Arayot, to be strong, and believe me, it's the best life. The mamash without Yetzirah, we can have, enjoy the bit on the life, because with doing your Avera, after it's feeling so bad. But who doesn't do Avera, feel all the time happy, because he knows that he's a man, he's strong. Hashem will help that to never listen to the Yetzirah. Amen. And will be holy. Amen. Kedir Ratzon.